Let me tell you a very interesting story. This is the story of a greedy dog from Panchatantra. So what happened was, one day this greedy dog was traveling along and he was crossing a river with a chicken bone in his mouth. Now he stopped and he looked down into the river while crossing. There he saw another dog with another chicken bone in his mouth. So this dog wondered, I have a chicken bone with me and there is another dog who has another chicken bone. So if I bark at him and scare him away, I'll have two chicken bones all to myself. So what the greedy dog did was, he barked. But then, to his disappointment, he found that the chicken bone he had, it fell off and he lost it. This dog was fooled by his own picture. His own picture? Yes, that is right. This dog was fooled by his own image in the water. There was no other dog. So what do you think happened over here? Let us take another example. Every day before going to school, don't you want to know how you're looking? Whether you're looking good or whether you can look even better? How do you see yourself? You see your image and you find out how you're looking. That image on which you see it is known as your reflection. And the object on which you see it is the mirror. The mirror helps you see your own reflection, and thereby you can say whether or not you're looking good enough for school. So, where else are mirrors used? Mirrors are used in cars. The mirror that you see over here is being used to see what is coming from behind. This mirror is attached to this car, and the driver uses it to see how many other cars are behind his car. So, can you tell me where else mirrors are used? Look at this picture. Over here, a doctor is using a mirror for checkup. Can you tell me why he does so? This doctor is using a mirror because while he examines you, this mirror helps him see parts of your body in a better and more focused manner. So, what do you think make mirrors such good reflectors? Why are mirrors always used? And what are the reasons behind them being good reflectors? Let us find out what should be the properties. We learned that when a surface is smooth, light falling on it undergoes specular reflection. And when a surface is rough, light falling on it undergoes diffuse reflection. Specular reflection was when a parallel beam of light reflected parallelly, and diffuse reflection was when a parallel beam got scattered. So when you're standing in front of the mirror, you would obviously want a parallel reflection. You wouldn't want the light to get scattered. So the surface of the mirror should be smooth. That is our first criterion for a good reflector. Let us find out if there are any other criteria. Take a look at this video. In this video, a man and a woman are walking towards one another. They want to cross each other and go on their paths, but soon they find they are unable to do so. They hit a glass in between them. Now, why could they not see this glass? It is because light passed very easily through this glass, and that is why they were not able to see the glass. Now, what did we learn about objects through which light can pass very easily? Such objects are known as transparent objects. Transparent objects are those objects through which light passes very easily and through which we can see very clearly. So clearly, transparent objects are bad reflectors. Now, what do you think will take place when we consider an opaque object? An opaque object will obviously not let light pass through it. So all the light falling on the opaque object will be reflected. So an opaque object is a good reflector. So the second criterion that is fulfilled is the object must be opaque. So what are the conditions that we learned so far? That an object must be smooth and it should be opaque to be a good reflector. Do you think there are any other properties that it must satisfy? Let us take a look. What is a good absorber of light? A good absorber of light is that on which if light falls, little or almost no amount is reflected back. That is, most of the light that is falling on the surface is absorbed. So clearly, a good absorber of light is a bad reflector. But what if the object is a bad absorber of light? Well, in that case, when light falls on a bad absorber, most of it is reflected, and thus this reflected beam reaches our eyes. So a bad absorber of light is a good reflector. So can we say that this is a favorable criterion? Yes. So what are the three criteria that we learned so far? Properties that a good reflector of light must have are the following. The first property should be, it should be smooth. The second property should be, it should be opaque. And the third, it should be a bad absorbent of light. So what do you think? Do you think this mirror is satisfying all the properties? Yes. This mirror is smooth. It is opaque. And it is also a bad absorber. Now you must be wondering that a mirror is made up of glass. And glass, as I told you earlier, is transparent. So how can this be satisfying all the properties for a good reflector? You will be interested to know that every mirror, although made of glass, is coated with a silver surface at the back. This silver surface is responsible for making the mirror opaque, and it is on this silver surface that light is reflected. So the mirror coated with this silver surface enables it to become a good reflector, thereby satisfying all these three properties. So taking a quick recap, what did we learn? We learned that we can see our own image in a mirror through reflection. What are the properties that a good reflector must have? A good reflector must be smooth. It must be opaque. And must also be a bad absorber of light. So how is a mirror satisfying all these criteria? A mirror is always coated with a silver surface at the back. This silver surface allows it to be opaque. And the property of the mirror is already that it has a smooth surface and it is a bad absorber of light. So a mirror being coated with silver surface satisfies all these three properties.